Good morning. All right, please be seated. Before we begin, I would like to thank our vocalist, Anissa Clay Zulia, for the singing of our national anthem. Wasn't that great? Fantastic. Anissa is a senior in the College of Visual and Performing Arts, majoring in vocal performance in the Dewberry School of Music. She will graduate next spring. Anissa will join us again later for the singing of our alma mater. I would also like to thank the best band in the land, the Green Machine. And our very own Dr. Michael Nickens. That's right. Thank you, Doc Nix. You know, at the place where George Mason University occupies, we give greetings and thanksgivings to the recognized Virginia tribes who have lovingly stewarded these lands for millennia, including the Rappahannock, the Pamunkey, the Upper Mattaponi, the Chickahominy, the Eastern Chickahominy, the Nanisamon, the Monacan, the Mattaponi, the Potawomenic, and Nottoway, past and future, and to the Piscataway tribes who have lived on both sides of the river for time immemorial. Your education is a credit to the land that has received you. The good you do in this world is the harvest of the soil upon which you have stood, sat, and lived. How plentiful that harvest will turn out to be in your lifetime is now up to you. It's a good cause for this celebration today. Look, I am so very pleased to congratulate the class of 2023. You made it. Now, joining our graduates, faculty, and staff today are loved ones who come from throughout the Commonwealth, across the nation, and some who've even flown in from other nations just to be a part of this celebration. To each of you, I extend a warm welcome to George Mason University, and for our online viewers and listeners, thank you for joining us as well. Today, we will honor 4,700 recipients of bachelor's, master's, and doctoral and law degrees, as well as more than 300 certificate recipients. Our graduates hail from 78 countries, 41 states, and a multitude of backgrounds this year. About one in four of the patriots we are honoring today is the first in the generation of their family to earn a four-year degree. Would our first-gen graduates please stand so that we can celebrate the family history you are making today? Please stand. Now, the reality is, all of our graduates are earning a degree from a university whose impact and stature rises by the day. Your final year here was the year George Mason University was finally recognized by consensus as one of America's 50 finest public universities. We are Virginia's best for social mobility. We're Virginia's best for innovation. Now, I can tell you that many of us have known this for quite some time, but now the nation and the world have finally caught up. Truly, it is indeed Mason's time, like it has been for so many, and may your Mason degree be a springboard to success. I will tell you that the value of that degree now has never been worth more than it ever has been. As I depart, all of you have weathered quite a journey to arrive to this day. Many of you came to Mason amid the pandemic, a challenge we worked through together to overcome, not only as members of this university community, but as citizens of the world. We continue to be tested by global events in a time of profound challenge and change. War and atrocities around the world affect you personally, and the climate crisis has begun to accelerate at an alarming pace. In short, your world is changing right before your eyes. To make sense of it all, you have an unprecedented volume of information at your fingertips to inform you. But you are also confronted with more misinformation and disinformation. More misinformation and disinformation than ever. Making your challenge to inform your own voice much more difficult. To be sure, no one can or should try to suppress your voice. You continue to be more civically engaged, more vocal, more active in shaping the world's landscape, not just reacting to it, and the world actually needs you to do that. Along with the freedom our society gives you to raise your voice, however, comes great responsibility. To learn the facts about the issues of our day from credible sources and to express them in ways that help us live up to the credo of George Mason University, to create a more peace and just and prosperous world. What do I say it's your responsibility? Why do I say it's your responsibility? Because America's becoming more crowded, more volatile, and more in need of informed and involved voices to lead it than ever before. True leadership demands the brightest minds, not just the loudest voices, to carry the day. And that burden of leadership demands that you be informed, not just impassioned. As graduates of the largest and most diverse public university in the Commonwealth of Virginia, and one of the most diverse institutions in the whole country, you are a time machine to the future, because you already look like what America is to come. And as such, you are best equipped to listen, learn, and engage on these polarizing issues, to seek understanding and common ground, and to work to ensure that disagreement does not collapse into incivility. A foundation of peace is not built on agreement. It's built on a bedrock of mutual respect. That is true for young children squabbling on the playground, spouses arguing in the kitchen, or factions warring in fault lines around the world. Gandhi said it best, the greatness of humanity, it is not in being human, but in being humane. That is your charge. I hope that your Mason education has prepared you to separate fact from fiction, to discern without demonizing, to listen as passionately as you speak, even when your heart races and your ears burn. Who better to bear the weight of lifting us out of our downward spiral than you, future leaders, who these past years have lived, learned, and engaged in one of the most diverse environments you will find. Mason's diversity of origin, identity, circumstance, and thought is what we proudly and affectionately call altogether different. It has caused some struggles and many triumphs, but it isn't just a Mason slogan. It's your future. It's our shared future. Now let me tell you briefly about the graduates we'll be honoring today. We have an IT major who exemplifies the opportunities open to Mason students. She served internships at Lockheed Martin, DataLock Consulting, AWS, SAS, and several other companies. She is also a Mason peer mentor and a research assistant. We have a criminology, law, and society major who is earning an accelerated master's degree in international security. She is one of the inaugural recipients of the Periton Scholarship in National Security and is a student trainee in the Department of Homeland Security, as well as a member of the Intelligence Community Network here at Mason. We have a biology major who is a first-generation graduate who has worked as an environmental field interpreter, translating environmental science content into engaging hands-on outdoor and hands-on outdoor programs for 4,500 seventh graders. And we have a bioengineering major who, as a teenager, came to the United States from her native Honduras for cancer treatment. She beat cancer and committed herself to helping others. She works part-time now in the Inova Health System as a rehab technician and in Mason's Applied Biosensing Lab, developing wearable ultrasound technology for quantitative assessment of musculoskeletal injuries. Next up for her, it's med school or the military. As you can tell, this is an impressive group. You are an impressive group we're honoring today.